Hello, Jess Too Good here. Today I'm taking a look at the LEGO Mickey and Minnie Mouse buildable figure set. This released July 1st for $180, 1,739 pieces, and this was sent to me early by LEGO to review, but all opinions in this video are my own. Pretty straightforward, but the set includes two buildable figures for Mickey and Minnie Mouse and some side accessories that are buildable. So let's take a look at the Mickey figure first. So these are based on the couple's modern vintage appearance. I know it's weird to say modern vintage, but basically Disney has a style for Mickey Mouse if it's using this modern appearance, and this is in line with that style. Now both figures have a little platform which they stand on. The platforms use a bunch of tiles, but this big tile for each of the characters that has a printed signature of the character, which I really like. And they also use these airplane windows, which have these translucent purple sparkly little panels. The design of that I can't really do justice. It looks fantastic in person and gives each of these stands almost a film trim. I guess that's what they were going for to make these look like film reels, and it works really well. For Mickey Mouse, you could see there's a cluster of bricks to the left that are kind of slanted, and his left leg rests on that cluster. And it's a little bit of a tight fit because it's just kind of hard to line it up. But once you do have it lined up, Mickey is on there rather secure. As for the right foot, you can't even remove that as that has a pin connection, so you can rotate it a bit if you'd like, but that's about as much movement as you'd get. And there's a lot of interesting part usage, like you have these 2x4 bricks at the ends of the boots. They're trying to capture this rubber hose style, which the design of that cartoony look is captured really well with a lot of round pieces. This tube piece I was just not even familiar with, which has a Technic axle hole in the middle, and you could connect those two. They use that little barrel piece, which in that red coloring actually makes for some pretty good pant holes. The design of this are some of these corner brick pieces, which are very round and just kind of make for Mickey's pants. They also have his tail attached to the back, which is a hinge connection, and you can move that back and forth. The tail design, pretty logical using some of those horn or fang pieces. More of those tubes with the axle holes I'm not familiar with. Also, these glove printed designs, which use one of those front car hood pieces, and that has a glove printing there. The fingers are all three fixed right here. This thumb, though, is clipped on, so you can move it up and down. For the right arm, it holds the guitar. The guitar itself is an easy removed accessory where it only attaches with these two studs right here to the palm of the hand. Now, this design is the same build with those fixed three fingers and that one clipped finger, and also that printed glove piece. The hands rotate at the base. Mickey's trouser buttons are just 2x2 circular tiles. Also, for his stomach, there's a lot of slope pieces which give some nice shaping to it. As for Mickey's head, you can move these mouse ears as well as this nose right here up and down. This design actually uses one of those newer, older style helmet pieces in black to just kind of attach to a LEGO minifigure head, and actually makes for a pretty nice part usage if you ask me. There's a very interesting piece with the panel for the face where it almost seems like it's a dual molded half panel. And at the back, we have more of those big round corner bricks, as well as some more shapes to just kind of smooth out the back. And the book build provides our only stickers of the set with two on the cover, and opening up right in the middle, there's two more as just photos inside the scrapbook. Pretty adorable, but it does kind of suck that this isn't Lego-fied and they're just pictures of the characters. But still, that's it for the book build. Moving on from Mickey and his accessories, let's take a look at Minnie and her accessories. The design of this has a similar framework, but there are definitely some differences. Once again, lovely stand design where we have this printed large tile piece. Also, the film reel design, which again just blows my mind on that color they use, and also how well that came out using some unconventional combinations with the airport window piece and some panels. Her shoe build is a little bit different from Mickey's. Following up her legs, though, this design for the skirt uses some nice printed pieces with these two parts at the front, as well as two more at the back. And then these parts at the side, which you get two of, all fantastic, nice exclusive prints. And moving on to her hands, you can see that she has the same glove design that Mickey Mouse had, and those have the same rotation with a pin connection or Technic axle connection. And then at the back, we have the same connection for the mouse tail, which you can move back and forth on that hinge piece. And one of her accessories is this flower pot. Much like Mickey's guitar, some studs at the back connect this to Minnie's hand. We just got those four studs there. I like the build for the flowers themselves, where they use these giant flower pieces, connect it to some of those fang or horn pieces, as I like to say. And it makes for a pretty good sized flower pot for a figure of this size. It's pretty adorable and simplistic. Build for the torso is just as round as Mickey Mouse's. And for the head, same rotation with the ears on miniature ball joints. Also, we have that dual molded half panel piece with the design of the eyes right there. The nose that moves up and down. The little bit of a mouth. And this flower hat right here, which is actually pretty adorable. I like how they use a piece that's usually used for a stud shooter, as well as one of these round dome pieces. And it all comes together for a design that works very well for the parts they used. Either way, having the two built side to side, I'm starting to notice that either A, my Mickey Mouse is leaning forward, or B, my Minnie Mouse is leaning backwards. One of them is just not positioned right, and it's making the other one a little bit more forward or a little bit more backward. Who knows, though? They both look great side by side, in my opinion, but we'll go to all that in the final verdict. I just want to take a look at one more thing, which is the tripod build. Out of all the accessories you build in this set, my favorite is probably this older style camera as well as a tripod. The tripod itself is something I don't see built too much in Lego. And then getting this older style camera with these interesting round corner pieces was kind of surprising to me. So these pieces are 2x2 round corner pieces. And let me know if these have appeared in any sets before, because they just don't look familiar to me. But I thought that was a very interesting piece that I haven't seen before. But either way, the camera rotates at the base. You can also rotate this part at the side. And you can remove the camera from the tripod just by lifting it up where it only connects to these two studs. And now you have the camera on its own. But either way, that's it for the build of the set. Let's take a look at the packaging and then the final verdict. The box is one of those boring 18 plus boxes, but I think it works pretty well since these characters are mostly black and white on this box. And the back just shows some different shots and some more historical pictures of the two. There's two premium instruction booklets included with the set. The first one has some info on the history of these characters, as well as some info on the history of this project, even with a little appearance of Pool Toy Pluto, which is an old Lego set. So overall, once I have these all built, like, I don't have much bad to say about the builds. The builds are fantastic. It's interesting how they get these cartoony rubber hose characters into Lego form. You expect them to be very cube or block-like, but they're very round and cartoony-like, which is how they should be. These are two iconic cartoon characters. The worst part is the price, though. $180 for these two figures just doesn't feel worth it. At most, I'd say $150 would still feel overpriced, but more in line with some other sets. But really, ideally, it should be about $120 at most. These feel about $50 to $60 per figure, though they are a little bit more premium in their display stand appearance. This is something that's meant to be displayed and not really posed or played around with. And it works like that with how all these bricks come together for a very round and interesting rubber hose shape. Of all things considered, I'd rate this one a B, where it's just the price weighing it down so much. This just doesn't feel worth it for $180. But if you do get it, you'll have a joy building this and then just putting it on display and seeing how all those pieces come together. But what do you guys think? Am I being too easy with this set, or am I being too harsh? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. I'll see you guys later. Peace out. Bye.